जय हिंद एवरीवन, मायसेल्फ रविंद्र कुमार, असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर इन इलेक्ट्रिकल इलेक्ट्रॉनिक्स इंजीनियरिंग डिपार्टमेंट इन एकेजी इंजीनियरिंग कॉलेज गाजियाबाद। टुडे आई एम प्रेजेंटिंग द टॉपिक वायर्स एंड केबल्स। दिस इज कमिंग अंडर फिफ्थ यूनिट इलेक्ट्रिकल इंस्टॉलेशंस इन द सब्जेक्ट बेसिक इलेक्ट्रिकल इंजीनियरिंग, एंड दिस इज इंटेंडेड फॉर बेसिकली फॉर द स्टूडेंट्स हु आर इन फर्स्ट ईयर who are taking this subject of basic electrical engineering. And other than that, those students who are having such topics in their course studies, they can also take the benefit of it. So under this topic, I will be covering various types of wires and cables, their usage, where they are used, and how to select those wires and cables as per the use. So if we see it, these are the contents in this. We are to discuss different type of wires. We have to discuss different type of wires and different types of cables. So if we say it, in the different type of wire, basically there are six types of wires, and that depends upon the type of insulation or the wire. So depending upon that, we name the different type of wires on the basis of the insulation which is put over the wire. So this is vulcanized Indian rubber wire. This is, in short, we call it VIR wire. That is one type. So this basically vulcanized Indian rubber, this is the type of insulation which is put over the wire. So that's why the name given to it is VIR wire, vulcanized Indian rubber wire. Second type is tough rubber sheath wire. This is TRS. That is again a type of insulation. Next type is polyvinyl chloride PVC wire. This is another insulation type. So on that basis, the name is PVC wire, polyvinyl chloride wire. Fourth is lead alloy sheath wire. Fifth one is weatherproof wire, which is used in case of typical weather conditions. And last category is flexible wire. So this is used for portable devices basically, like laptop, mixer grinder, heater, and this electric iron. So similar type of devices where the portability is the issue. So there we are using flexible wire. So now if we see in the wires, the size and type of the wire or cable that should match the power rating required for their use. If we require higher power to be supplied with the help of wire or cable, then the thickness of that wire or cable will be required more. The reason for this is when we are to supply high power, that means power is given by voltage into current. So we are to supply a large amount of power at a given voltage level, so that time the current that will also be high, since a current is P upon V from this equation. And when at a given voltage we are to supply a large amount of power, so that time current will also be high. And for large current, the resistance should be small, and we know resistance is given by rho L by A. So for small resistance, cross section area should be more. So that's why we require thicker wire for carrying this larger current. That way we have these specifications. Now the wires, they can be used in domestic and small industrial wiring and in the appliances also. So this diagram is showing the wires. So these are wires basically, and this is the insulation put over the wire. So as in the previous slide, we have seen various types of insulations, they can be put over the wire depending upon the requirement. So on that basis, we categorize the wires in different categories that already we have seen in the previous slide and discussed about this. Next, in cables, they are used in industries, distribution line, which is distributing the power for consumers, and transmission lines, which are supplying the power from one location to another location. So these are the cables, all these are cables shown in this diagram. So that way we have wires and cables which are used for different purposes. Now when we talk about various types of wires, so first type is VIR wire, which is known as vulcanized Indian rubber wire, which is the type of insulation. So here we see it in this diagram. The details are there, what are the various parts of this wire and what are the names and specifications for that. So if we see it, we have this copper wire or aluminium wire, that is the material of wire, and tinning is done for that copper or aluminium, and this tinning is done so in order to protect the wire against corrosion from VIR. So this is the tinned wire that is shown in the diagram. This is tinning of the wire which is done in order to protect it from the corrosion from VIR. VIR is vulcanized Indian rubber. Another thing, if you see, this is vulcanized Indian rubber. This is the insulation type that is put over this. Then we have cotton tape and cotton braiding that is done over this. This is cotton tape or cotton braiding. Then this is bitumen, that is this. So all these are the various parts in the construction for this VIR wire, and this wire is suitable for low and medium voltage supply. So where we require low voltage supply or medium voltage supply, that time we can use this VIR wire at those places. Now if we see in detail about this VIR wire, that is vulcanized Indian rubber wire. So this wire mainly consists of a tinned conductor having rubber coating, that already we have discussed in the previous slide why it is there. Tinning of the conductor that prevents the sticking of rubber to the conductor, that's why tinning is done. Thickness of the rubber, that is mainly dependent upon operating voltage for which the wire is designed. That means if we are to take higher voltage for the wire, that time accordingly the thickness of rubber will increase, and if we are to use the wire for lower voltage value or lower voltage level, that time the thickness of rubber will be reduced accordingly. Then a cotton braiding that is done over the rubber insulations so as to protect the conductor against moisture, surrounding atmosphere moisture that is there. So to protect this from that moisture, this cotton braiding is done over the rubber insulation. And finally, the final finishing is done with the help of wax in order to provide cleanliness for the wire, so that the look is proper and there is no problem on the surface, that will be smooth surface accordingly. Next type is TRS wire, that is tough rubber sheath wire. In this type of wire, it is a modification basically for VIR wire that we have seen in the previous slide. It is consisting of ordinary rubber coated conductors with an additional sheath of tough rubber. So here the insulation is tough rubber, that's why the name is tough rubber sheath. Now this layer that provides better protection against moisture, surrounding air moisture or surrounding atmospheric moisture, and wear and tear also. Plus it provides extra insulation for the wire. So that's why this is the additional benefit or advantage by having this tough rubber sheath insulation over the wire. These wires are generally available in single conductor or two conductor or three conductor. In that form, these wires are available. Further, if we see, next type is PVC wire, that is polyvinyl chloride. That is again a type of insulation. So this is polyvinyl chloride. So here in this diagram that is shown, this PVC wire. So if we see the various parts of it, we can see this is copper or aluminium conductor. If we are to require high conductivity, that time we will select copper as a conductor. If we are to have somewhat smaller conductivity, then we can use aluminium also. Then we have this PVC insulation, that is this shown in this diagram, that is PVC insulation, polyvinyl chloride insulation. And then if you see the voltage range, this is available in 600 or 660 or 1100 voltage range, this wire is available. And if we see the use of this wire, this is widely used, having long life, and this wire is durable against water, heat, oil and UV light. UV light stands for ultraviolet light. So for all such, the durability of wire is there, water, heat, oil and UV light, against all such we have the durable wire for this purpose. So that's why this PVC wire is widely used for industries and domestic applications. Then next type is lead alloy sheath wire. This is another type of insulation. That's why the name of the wire is lead alloy sheath wire, which is put over the wire, this lead alloy sheath insulation. Ordinary wires that can be used at dry places where there is no moisture or a very small moisture content, but for damp places are those places where there is moisture content, then these wires are covered with continuous lead sheath so as to protect from that moisture. The layer of lead covering is very thin, and this thickness is in the order of or in the range of 0.1 centimeter. These wires provide little mechanical protection also for the wires. Next category is weatherproof wire, which are used so as to protect from surrounding typical weather conditions. The wire is protected from those typical weather conditions. These wires are used for outdoor use, that is providing a service connection from overhead line to the building. Like we have distribution lines which are distributing the power for the consumers, so those are overhead line, and for consumer building, for getting connection from overhead line to the consumer building, these wires are used, which are known as weatherproof wire, so that they can bear typical weather conditions and there is no problem with these wires or very little problem due to typical weather condition. In this type of wire, the conductor is not tinned. There is no requirement of tinning, and the conductor is covered with three braids of fibrous yarn, and this is saturated with waterproof compound. So that is the specialty of this weatherproof wire. Next we have flexible wire. So these wires are required where we require flexibility so that we can bend the wire easily. That will not create any problem with that. So like in laptop, mixer grinder, heater, cooler, or any other such type of portable device, electric iron, there we require these flexible wires where portability is there. So these wires consist of number of strands. Strand means this is a very thin wire. Instead of a single conductor, we use this very thin wires, which are known as strands. So strand is a very thin conductor basically. The conductor is insulated with PVC material, polyvinyl chloride. That is the insulating material used over this conductor. And these wires are very useful for household portable devices or appliances, where flexibility of the wire is more important. Like example, we have seen already in laptops, electric iron, geyser, mixer, heater, grinder, all there they are having such type of wires. Now if we talk about specifications for these flexible wire, so such type of specifications are given 40/0.1 mm. So this first figure 40, that represents number of strands in the wire, 40 strands, and strands already we have seen what is strand, that is a very thin wire. So 40 thin wires are used rather than using only single wire, and each strand or each thin wire is of thickness 0.1 mm, that is the dia of the wire or thickness of the wire, and the current carrying capacity, that is normally 6 ampere, which is used for household purposes. So this is the specification. Similarly, suppose I write 60/0.2 mm, so that time again similar to this first figure, this 60, that will represent the number of strands in the wire, and this second figure 0.2 mm, that will represent the dia of each strand. So that way we specify the specifications for flexible wires. Next we have cables. So if we see, a power cable is an assembly of two or more electrical conductors. So that means it may have two or more than two conductors. usually held together with an overall sheath. This assembly is used for transmission of electrical power. That means we can transmit power with the help of it. Power cables, they may be installed as permanent wiring within the buildings, or they may be buried in the ground, or they may run overhead, or they may be exposed. So that type of depending upon our use, these type of installations may be done for power cables. Flexible power cable, they are used for portable devices, mobile tools and machinery. For those requirement, we use flexible power cables. So, if we see with the help of this diagram plus specification, we can see cables, they are basically classified or sorted by number one on the basis of insulation or type of insulation. So, it may be cotton covered, that is one type of insulation, another one silk coated, asbestos covered, rubber coated, PVC coated. So, all these are the insulations which can be there over the cable. So, that is insulation type. On this basis, we can classify the cable. Another criteria, type of the conducting material. Conducting material may be copper or aluminium. On that basis, we can classify the cable. So, this diagram is showing the cable. So, this is complete cable structure. These are the wires inside this cable, these wires. Then, shape. On the basis of shape, we can classify. This may be flat shape cable or round shape cable. That may be there. That is shown in this diagram. Then, mechanical protection. It is armored cable or unarmored cable. That may be there. On that basis, we can classify the cable. Unarmored or armored. So, that way we can classify. Unarmored is also there. So, this is shown in this diagram. Then, on the basis of voltage, it may be low voltage or it may be high voltage. So, if we are to use a cable for low voltage requirement, that time it will be low voltage grade, or if otherwise it may be high voltage grade also. So, that way we can classify the cables. Then, if we see the constructional features of a cable. So, these are the various parts in the cable, conductor or core, insulation, metallic sheath, bedding, armoring and serving. So, if we see in this diagram, this is the conductor, this is the innermost part of the cable, that's why we call it core also. This can be written core also, since this is the innermost part of the cable. Then over it we have this insulation, over that we have this metallic sheath like lead sheath, then over it we have bedding, then armoring over it, and finally the last part is serving, so that we can make service connection for the cable with the help of external circuit. Now, if we see the type of cable, it may be belted cable which can be used for the voltage level up to 11 kV, that is 11,000 volt. In these cables, cores are not in circular shape, that we can see here in the diagram, that core or conductor, they are not of circular shape, that is shown here, this is not of circular shape. The cores are insulated from each other by the help of impregnated paper. This is, we can see here, this is paper insulation, this is impregnated paper. Impregnated paper is that paper where there is no moisture content in the paper. So, that is used between the cores, so that moisture will not create any problem. And the gaps are filled with the help of fibrous material like jute, that we can see here, this jute filling is there between the gaps. The gaps are filled with the help of it. And the belt is covered with the lead sheath, that we can see this is covered with the help of lead sheath. So, all these are the different parts. This is the paper belt. So, that is also shown in the diagram. So, this is all about this belted cable. What are the different parts in this and why they are there, or what is the use of those parts. Then we have oil filled cables. In the oil filled cables, if we say it, the channels or ducts are provided within or adjacent to the cores. So we can see here, these are the cores or conductors, conductor or core. These are this. Then oil ducts, they are there, channels or oil ducts, that is there. They are provided within or adjacent to the core, through which oil under pressure is circulated. So through these oil ducts, the oil is circulated under pressure. Why it is there? Oil is required for cooling purpose. Since when we are using these power cables, so they are carrying large power through them. So that heating is there due to a large current passing through the cable. So to cool the cable, we require this oil. That is the purpose of this. So this oil is circulated under pressure through the ducts. It consists of concentric conductor, but built around a hollow cylindrical steel spiral core, which acts as a channel for oil. That we can see in this diagram. This oil duct is there, lead sheath is there, paper insulation is also there, impregnated paper that we have seen, and serving finally. So all these parts are there in this oil filled cable. Then if we see, next one is gas pressure cable. So these cables are having inert gas that is used at high pressure, that is introduced between the lead sheath and dielectric. So here we can see, this is conductor inside, that we can see, and this is triangular shape basically. SF6 gas, that is sulfur hexafluoride gas, that is used in the cables, and pressure that is maintained near about 12 to 15 atmospheric pressure. So that's why an inert gas at high pressure that is introduced between the lead sheath and dielectric, and that's why these cables are known as gas pressure cables. So in this discussion, we have discussed the various types of wires which are used for different purpose or different usage. Similarly, different types of cables which are used depending upon the requirement. So this is all about this. In the next lecture, we will be meeting for next topic of discussion. Thanks for this.